Hi, friends. We're back with another story. This one is sort of a short but sweet story. It's really simple and I think really beautiful. And speaking of beautiful, Elsie changed her hair bow. So you might remember the yellow hair bow in her hair. But this one is pink and this time she's wearing it like a headband and it hangs down so far in the back. But I think you look great. Oh, I know. Oh, she's embarrassed. No, you don't have to be embarrassed. She's very demure, Elsie. And Elsie is so excited to offer you this book. It's just called A Tree is Nice by Janice May Dry. And the pictures are by Marc Simont. So what do we got? We got a girl, got a watering can, a little tree, big tree, cat, dog. What more do we need? I think we'll be good with this. So without further ado, that means I'm going to start right away. Let's start. Here's this picture of a tree. So interesting. And I wonder if this is like a lake or the ocean. A tree is nice. And now we have another big tree, a small tree. Trees are very nice. They fill up the sky. They fill up both of these pages too. You know, when you go outside and you could be somewhere where there's so many trees that you look up and all you see are leaves and the sunlight coming through. They go beside the rivers and down the valleys. They live up on the hills. So we can see a willow tree, the trees up on the hills, so many different types. And here's a friend fishing. That's fun. Have you ever been fishing? I haven't been since I was probably your age, since I was a little kid, but I'd like to go again. I really enjoyed it. Trees make the woods. They make everything beautiful. What a beautiful sunny day. Even if you have just one tree, it's nice too. A tree is nice because it has leaves. The leaves whisper in the breeze all summer long. So look, they've only got one tree, but it's enough to make shade for this horse. And you know what they're talking about? The leaves whispering where you can hear the wind coming through the tree and it makes sounds like shh. I love that sound. I think it's so soothing. In the fall, the leaves come down and we play in them. We walk in the leaves and roll in the leaves. We build playhouses out of the leaves. Then we pile them up with our rakes and have a bonfire. So make a big pile of leaves, and then they light it on fire. I don't know how advisable that is. I think what they need is some adult supervision, but maybe with an adult there, it's okay. A tree is nice because it has a trunk. That's this part. And limbs. Those are these parts. We can climb the tree and see over all the yards. We can sit on a limb and think about things, right? Look at the, just having a little sit and think. Or play pirate ship up in the tree. It's playing pirate ship. So not only do trees have limbs, people have limbs, right? Your arms, those are limbs. Your legs, those are limbs. Same for Elsie. She's got these two front limbs, these two arms. Our little back ones, you know? Yeah. Thank you for helping me to demonstrate. So that's an interesting word to learn, limb. L-I-M-B. And the B is silent. If it is an apple tree, we can climb it to pick the apples. Have you ever gone apple picking? It's so nice to eat an apple fresh off the tree. I love apples. I could really eat an apple every day. What about you, Elsie? Elsie prefers bananas. That makes sense. Cats get away from dogs by going up the tree. So you can see the dog down here barking, and the cat's safe up in the tree because the cat can get up there, but the dog can't. Birds build nests in trees and live there. Sticks come off of the trees too. We can draw in the sand with sticks. So you can see a stick from the tree. And he's drawn a little house with a chimney, and a boat, and a sun. A tree is nice to hang a swing in, or a basket of flowers. It's a good place to lean your hoe while you rest.
A hoe is a type of tool like this that we use to dig dirt, so especially in a garden, so we can see, you know, they've been working planting this garden, but now he's resting his tool, his hoe, and having a nap.
A tree is nice because it makes shade. The cows lie down in the shade when it is hot.
Just like that horse we saw enjoying the shade before, the farm where there was only one tree. So even a little bit of shade helps on a hot day.
People have picnics there too, in the shade. And the baby takes his nap in his buggy in the shade.
So we can see so much going on. Climbed up in the tree, resting against the tree. Fell asleep while reading. That happens to me sometimes. Having a picnic and then the baby in its buggy having a nap.
A tree is nice for a house to be near. The tree shades the house and keeps it cool.
So we got this big tree and this big one in the back shading the house. So the shade's not just for, like, you know, if you're outside, it can also help you keep cool if you're inside, which is pretty cool.
The tree holds off the wind and keeps the wind from blowing the roof off the house sometimes. A tree is nice to plant. You dig the biggest hole you can and put the little tree in. Then you pour in lots of water and then the dirt. So we can see that here. You got the hole, the tree, the water, some dirt, and a shovel. Okay, and then we can see hanging the shovel back up, and there's the tree, freshly planted.
Every day for years and years, you watch the little tree grow. You say to people, I planted that tree. So watching it through the winter, and there you're saying, I planted that tree. That's kind of cool to plant a tree and watch it grow. I've never done that.
They wish they had one, so they go home and plant a tree too. So, that was A Tree is Nice by Janice May Dry, pictures by Marc Simont. What do you think, Elsie? What did you think of it? Uh-huh. Elsie said her favorite part was the pictures, and I totally agree, right? Like, oh yeah, she loved those pictures. And they were so pretty. I like that some of them were in color, but some were in black and white. And it made me want to go spend time out under a tree. So I hope if you get a chance today, you can spend a little time under a tree. You could read, you know, I love reading, or draw, or just rest and think. Do you ever do that? Okay, Elsie says she prefers, if she's like needs to have a good think, to go near water, like near a river or a stream, near the ocean. She says that helps her to think near water. And I like that too, but see if today you can get outside and spend some time with a tree. Thanks for reading, friends. Keep reading.